In this video, I just want to show you Modo's reduction tool. This is going to be a big help, especially in creating assets for Dota 2 or any other video game for that matter. In Dota 2, when you create an item, like for instance, this shoulder item that you see here, which is the default item for the Necrophos character in Dota 2, you have two items that you actually have to create. You have to create an LOD0 and an LOD1. These are two items that are virtually identical, except for their resolution. In this case, if you take a look at the shoulders here, these shoulders are 1,215 triangles. And I know this because it's the only active mesh item in this scene right now. And over here in the lower right-hand corner, you can see GL listed as 1,215. That's the number of triangles that are in our scene presently. So we have 1,215 triangles. Now, if I also come over to the dota2.com/workshop/requirements page for Necrophos, you'll see that we have information on the LOD 0 and 1 triangle limits. In this case, the shoulders, 0 is 1,250 and 1 is 700. And so this object that is 1,215 triangles will fit into LOD 0, but it won't fit into the LOD 1. So if we want to go ahead and create the LOD 1, it can be a painful process. We can go in there and select edges, loop select with L, backspace to get rid of that. Now we have less polys in our scene, as you can see, but that's time consuming. So right click on this, duplicate your mesh item, turn off the original, come over to the polygon modeling menu, come to the reduction tool, left click and drag out, and you can see by taking a look right down here where it says GL that I now am reducing the number of polys down to, in this case, 704. It did a great job of kind of preserving the mesh as I reduced it. I gotta say I'm very impressed at how well it did, but I did have some problems. If I go ahead and I reduce this any further, reduction tool, and bring that down to 704 again, I don't like what it does down here. It got rid of the depth. If I undo that, you'll be able to see what I mean. I don't like that. All right, so I can go ahead and select these polys, preserving that section. Press the left bracket on the keyboard, and that will invert your selection. And now, if I run the reduction tool and take a look at where it lists how many tries I have, I can bring that all the way down to, this time it hits exactly 700, and I also preserve the areas that I wanted to. Now, furthermore, if I take a look at the UV map for the character, I'll toggle these both off and just switch back and forth. Here's my high-res model. You can see the UVs are very clear. And again, low-res, even though I reduced things so much, still maintain the continuity of the islands and the general shape of the object extremely well. So Modo's reduction tool is going to save you loads of time, and hopefully you find this useful.